Well, you've joined me here today at Packington Summers Fishery. It's a beautiful place, to be honest, and it's a cold winter's day, but I'm still fancying it for a few fish. And Packington is very typical of a lot of commercials that I like to go to, where I've got a far bank to fish to, I've got some features to fish to across, and that side of the lake generally tends to be where the fish back off to now it's got cold. There's some great big carp and lovely F1s in here. I'm going to have a look at some tactics that I'm going to use to put more fish in your net this winter. So what I've done today is gone for the ultimate winter setup. First of all, I'm comfy. Look at this, I'm on the old 360 seat here, and to be fair, it's really cold. I'm not expecting loads of bites. I love going fishing in winter, but I need to be comfy. So this revolving seat is going to give me just that. I've kept everything dead simple. I've got a small hooded side tray here. On that side tray, all I've got is some micro pellets and some maggots. It really doesn't get any simpler. I was set up within 10 minutes today getting ready, which is really nice if you maybe just want a short winter session or just want to get out on the bank and catch a few fish. With this setup, for me, it was always going to be looking at a little bit of feeder fishing. You can see here across the lake, all the cover is on the far bank and the water's really clear today. So I know that the fish will have backed off towards that far bank area. So I need the right tools to go and chase after them. So, rod and reel set up as always. I've got the Magnitude 420 on here with some 020 sinking feeder mono on that reel. That's very important actually, because I'm only going to be using really light, small feeders. So I don't want big, thick, heavy mono on my reel for winter. I don't need it anyway. The fish aren't going to pull hard enough to worry me, but it means that I can cast these small feeders across to the other side of the lake easily without having a load of drag from heavy line. That's all teamed up with a nice soft rod. I've got my favourite 10-foot Superior SL in my hand. Beautiful rod, to be honest. Bends all the way through. Powers up just at the end if I need it to with a big fish. But it gives me ultimate control of the feeder and the fish, which is something that I'm really looking for when I'm coming out for a nice day like today. The feeder setup as well couldn't be any simpler. I've gone for the new ICM mini cage and mini maggot feeders. I'm not going to want to introduce a lot of bait today. I've only got the micro pellets and the maggots on my side tray. So I'm going to use these tools to try and find where the fish are rather than introducing loads of bait and scaring them off. So I've put the swivel stem in the cage feeder. I've got my free running traditional cage feeder set up here with a short twizzle boom and then a nice hook length. You can see I've got the 12 gram cage. I'm probably only going to put a few micros in there, maybe an odd maggot if I need to, and just I'm going to start by casting around probably 5 to 10 meters off that far bank and just see if I can find a few fish before I go chasing them across to that far bank. Down at the business end, I've got 014 AccuPower here, about 40 centimeter hook length, and then I've got a 14 SFL hook. Again, everything's balanced here. I'm not going really strong with tackle, but I know with a soft rod and this sort of line and hook, I'm gonna land pretty much everything I hook. I'd be very unlucky if I got broke today with the water being so cold. And this is why all this setup is perfect for winter. Come and have a look at how I'm loading it up, and we'll get out there and try and catch a few fish. Okay, can we have a little look at my den? So here's my small Ventolite side tray, and it's got a nice hood on it here. So even if it does snow or maybe a bit of rain, I've got everything covered up. You can see I can just fold that back and I've got access to all my baits, and it's dead simple what I've brought today. First of all, some 2mm Pro Feed pellets. all I've done with these is empty about a quarter of a bag into this bowl and just put a little bit of water. I've not sort of soaked them up or covered them. I've just put a little bit of water so they just about stick together, but not really, because I want to put a few maybe in the maggot feeder and also knit them tightly in that cage feeder. I don't want them all sloppy. I want them nice and firm so I can just knit them together so I haven't wetted them up too much. Then of course, all I've done is brought a pint of maggots, which if I'm being honest, is probably 3/4 of a pint too many, but I always feel bad buying less than a pint, so I always buy a pint anyway, typical. And all I've got is reds with a few whites in. Nothing very exciting, but very, very simple to catch me a lot of fish. Just got my hook lengths there if I need to. The only downside is my flask has had to go on the floor, which is a bit of a nightmare. But apart from that, I'm totally sorted for this situation. Now, let's look at how I'm going to approach it. So, I've got my setup. I've gone for the old free running. I have also brought a rod with me for inline, just if I want to have a little play. But this is my favoured setup where I can get away with it in winter. It's a free running rig. You see there the swivel. On the swivel stem, the ICM feeder can run up and down. And when I'm faced with this sort of situation here, I think the fish are going to be in the last quarter of the lake. So what I don't want to do is be going in straight away with a load of bait. I just want to really try and find them to begin with. So for dead simple to start with, I'm going to take this feeder and I'm going to put probably 12 or 15 maggots in it. I'm not going to put loads of maggots in it at all, because all I'm looking to do is just see if the fish are there. And you think about it, on the pole, what do we do when we fish a pole and the fish are within pole range? All we do is maybe tap in a dozen maggots and then wait for a bite. It shouldn't be any different on a feeder. You don't need to put loads of bait in to start with. So having mainly reds in there and a few whites, I'm going to put a couple of whites on the hook. I think maybe that'll stand out a bit. Don't know, water's quite clear, it might work, might not. So two whites on my size 14 SFL, and you can see there that I've got the maggots in there. Because it's cold, the maggots aren't really crawling a lot, they'll stay in nicely. When they get down on the bottom, they'll just eke out one at a time, and the fish come into this area and then hopefully find my maggot hook bait. So all I've done is I've clipped up at about 3/4 of the way across, so I'm just going to ping this out there and see if there's a fish sitting there. Absolutely perfect. So I haven't gone right over to that reed bed just to begin with. I've just kept it sort of, I don't know, probably 3 or 4 meters off, and I'm hoping that there's going to be a big F1 or a carp or something just living there. Just might be one there on its own. You just don't know. And when you come to these places in winter, there's loads of fish in them. So you've got to find them. They're not going to come to big heads of food. They're going to come and find you. So you can see there, I'll just flip my rod rest around. We're back. I'm going to give it about 5 minutes to see if there's one there. I can sit back and wait. Let's see what happens. Well, we're about 4 minutes and 30 into the first cast. Got the maggot feeder on. What we got, what we got? Water's lovely and clear, there he is. Oh, great big F1. So obviously I'm only using light tackle. But you can see there, the nice soft rod allows me to not worry too much about it. Got the clutch set as well. So it was a good decision to start casting there. Got him. Oh yeah, I tell you what, they're nice F1s in here. Very, very nice. Lovely dark fish, because the water is so clear. He's an absolute beast, look at him. They did tell me all the F1s are big, so I'm expecting some good ones today. To see if I can, might have to use two hands to get hold of him. There we go. A nice big, dark, chunky F1 to start us off. Very nice. He's gone for the old two maggots, hasn't he? So a good decision to start there. Just gives me an opportunity. I mean, that was the first cast of the day. Hopefully we've probably left a few maggots there as well. So maybe an odd fish will be milling around there now. And I can just explore that area for a little bit. And I'm just going to stick with this maggot feeder now for a little while and see if I can put a few fish in the net before I start thinking about maybe whether I want to introduce some pellets or something with a cage, or perhaps even go a little bit further. So I'm going to get back out there. I'm going for a dozen maggots once again. There's actually still one maggot left in the maggot feeder, which is really what I want. I don't want all the maggots just flooding out of the feeder straight away. I want the fish to basically come to this little pod of maggots, if you like, and there'll just be an odd one crawling out all the time. And being 12 gram, I can just flick this back out. Oh, lovely. So I can just flick that back out really nicely. It barely made a sound. And you can see the water's flat today. And it obviously didn't put that fish off. So let's see what happens, see if we can sneak another one. Now, hopefully Joe didn't capture the fact that I was actually on the phone there, you know, because when he got the chair, he can have a little nice sit back and send a WhatsApp message boasting about how you've had one first cast. That's been in the water not even a minute, and I've managed to go round again. So effectively, I've only put 20 maggots in the water and I'm playing my second fish, which is great, especially if I only wanted a short session. Tell you what, nice little left one. Not a huge one, but he's pound and a half at least. Great start to the session. What a start. Even the sun's coming out. Perfect. And if you're going to come for this sort of session in winter, you can see how easy it can be and how easy your gear can be. It just encourages me to get out a little bit more, if I'm being honest, because I know that I can set up nice and quickly with nice, efficient tackle and use it to catch some fish. He's had those as well. Look, there they are. Two maggots. Only a little one, probably a pound, pound and a half. Let's pop him in the keep net. So I'm already feeling that there's a few fish here and they're obviously just shoaled up just in front of that reed bed. So I've just had two in two chucks there, which is a great start to my day. And that second one came after a minute. I really wasn't expecting to bite so quickly after going in. And it just shows that those few maggots I left from the first cast have allowed a fish to gather there. But what's even more encouraging is this water is so clear. And that feeder is going in with such minimal disturbance that the fish obviously didn't back off. It was there straight away because I've caught it that quickly. And it's a great sign and just what I've come here to do, to be honest, because I just feel that they're so nice and cast and go in so well that I'm going to be able to search my peg with such efficiency without having to worry about the fact that I might scare some fish off. It might just allow me to catch them for a bit longer in a spot before I have to back off. You know what it's like again with the pole, you know, you're always trying to be nice and quiet, nice and precise, and hope that the fish gather. And that's hopefully what will happen here today. So again, I'm just going to give this 3 or 4 minutes now to see how we get on before I even think about issuing any more bites or anything like that. You know, searching the peg or anything I want to do has to be considered. So I need to think carefully about what's going to happen, and we'll see now if we get another one. Just dropped back in and I've got up to 3 or 4 fish now, which is nice. And they've all come from this same spot, but I want to talk to you a little bit about reading the tip, because the tip tells you everything, you know. The tip tells you whereabouts you may or may not find the fish. So it's not just a case of sitting back and enjoying a cup of tea, although you can obviously do that. You need to keep your eye on the tip to try and understand where the fish might be, or maybe what other fish might be in your peg. So a great example is here today. I haven't had a lot of liners yet, very, very few. And I think those that I have had have been more little plucks from small fish. So basically when the tip jags or makes little sharp movements, that tends to be smaller fish such as skimmers or roach or whatever it may be, almost plucking at your bait or maybe bumping into the feeder. The more sort of signs that you're looking for are those slow movements on the tip, a more traditional liner where the tip might go slow and then drop back or something like that. And if you're getting those sorts of indications, the likelihood is that the fish are somewhere close to your feeder, but shorter of where you are. Now, so far today, I haven't had any of those indications yet, which tells me that the fish are obviously, from where I've been catching them, little taps there, I think there might be a small fish on. Yep, a little small skimmer or something. So basically, I've caught three or four fish. I've now got a little skimmer on. I haven't had any liners, okay? So I think that the likelihood is the fish have just started to back off a little bit, maybe towards those reeds, maybe where they feel a bit safer after I've caught three or four. So when I cast the feeder out this time, I can either do one of two things. First of all, I can cast out with this maggot feeder on again and then put a little bit of extra distance on, or I could potentially change this feeder to a little cage and put some micro pellets in. Now, actually, that's what I'm gonna do, I think, first. The micro pellets are very handy because micro pellets are a lot stronger than what maggots are in terms of smell and attraction. So I can use this tiny little ICM cage to fill my feeder with micro pellets, and probably there's gonna be a good 50 or so micro pellets in that feeder. Not loads, but you can see there, I've just filled that up with some micro pellets. I've really wedged them in nice and tight because I feel like the fish aren't showing me any signs that they're around now where I am. I think they've backed off. So just before I go searching for them, I'm gonna use this little cage just to see if they'll come to me with a little bit of extra smell before they back off again. So next time, if I don't catch any fish with probably a couple of chucks on this, I'm gonna take the line clip off and go another meter closer to those reeds to see if I can get that second run. But we've had a lovely start. Let's see if the cage brings us another run. Well, I love it when a plan comes together. 3 minutes in on the cage and we've got one. So it was the case, I think, that they just wanted to come and have a little look at something a bit smellier, something a little bit different, because they clearly had backed off from that maggot feeder. And of course, the introduction of some pellets has just given it that little boost, and the fish has come in. I've still got maggots on the hook, but you could tell that they just needed something. And the choices were quite simple for me. I could either have explored a little bit further, but when you've got that little change of feeder in your armory, it just means that, here it is, look. It just means that you've got the option to do something different and catch a fish rather than sort of use all your tricks in one go. So you can imagine if I'd have gone long, which I'm going to have to do at some stage, I'd have already used that trick up. And by doing what I've just done there, I've got a definite one. Of course, I'm gonna have another chuck with this same setup now, see if it's worth another one. And if after two or three chucks, I feel like they have backed off, I haven't lost anything because I've put something in the net and I've kept that area of the peg nice and quiet where I can explore a bit further. So by working the swim, with just this really simple setup, I'm already looking like I'm gonna have a really nice day. So I'm gonna go back out there, just wedge these pellets back in again. Like I say, probably only 50. Just plop this in. Goes in so nice, these feeders. Barely making any noise. I'm still that decent distance off the reeds. So just before I put any more distance on, let's see if one, there might even be a quick one there because I've introduced the pellets. There might be another two or three fish kicking about. So let's have a look. Well, I've had a few liners and indications, but I can tell that it's not quite right. That introduction with a little bit of bait has caught me a couple of fish, and they're definitely coming to it, but it doesn't seem quite right to catching the fish, and I can see there's a few indications. So there is a few fish about here, so I just need to try a new trick. So what I'm gonna do is just get to my line clip, unclip it, and then I just take the line up to here twice. That's half a meter to that first eye. Clip it back on. That's given me an extra meter now past this little bit of bait that I've fed. So all I'm gonna do is put the maggot feeder back on, because again, I don't want to introduce loads of bait into the peg. I want to use that maggot feeder to try and nick them. Like I said, we're in winter mode now, well and truly. So if I can just find the maggot feeder, I found it. It's only a small tray, I'm sure I can find it. There we go. Just pop that maggot feeder back on. And this will allow me to search that little area past, like I did, basically what I did at the start. And hopefully there'll be one sat that I can catch pretty quickly. I've still got absolutely tons of water to explore here. You know, I can go left, I can go right, I can go closer to the reeds, but hopefully just off the back of that, that looks really good. Just off the back of that bait, I'm hoping that there's gonna be a fish there that wants a nice easy meal. And again, that feeder's going in so nice. I'm not having to worry too much about spooking anything off the back of it. So with any luck, there'll be a quick one here waiting for us. One thing that I want to talk to you about is the tip that I'm using in this rod. Now, before I talk to you about the tip I'm using, I was going to say it allows me to read the bites easily, but I'm just on that line where I've just gone past, and I had an indication first chuck, and that's just gone in. You've seen how quick that was. That's crazy. I was just going to tell you about the tips in the rod, which we'll get onto in a minute, but it's worth mentioning there. That is my second chuck. I was probably out 90 seconds or so on the first chuck, just past the bait. And what happened was I had some indications from small fish, which I felt might have been on or damaged my maggot. So I just wound it in and then just refilled it back up there. And I was just gonna tell you about the tips, and that has been in the water 10, 15 seconds, something like that. And it just shows what I've been trying to say about how important it is to search the peg. He's a real nice one. Look at him. Big, crafty, old F1 that knows what the crack, he knows what to do. He knows just to sit off the back and the other fish will blow the bait around for him. And he just backed off there. Look at that. That is an absolute cracker. Let's get the disgorge on him. Taking that double maggot, ooh, right down nicely there. Good job that disgorger floats. Just pop him in the net. And that's what I was saying about how those fish back off nicely. Rescue my floating disgorger. Because he's come straight to it, straight into that little area just off the back where he thinks he's safe. And he's resulted in a really quick fish. So basically I've got another chance to have another run here like I've had at the start. I mean, we're already up to about 7 or 8 F1s, which is a really good start, to be honest, and they're all a really nice stamp. So it's just very nice winter fishing, and we're probably only an hour or so into the session, so it just shows how effective it can be using a small amount of bait and just searching where the fish are. And you know, if I want to fish for 2-3 hours, I can. If I want to fish longer, I can, because I've got so much water here to explore that it means that I can put this feeder in really nicely. Maybe to the left, maybe to the right. I've got lots of options, but for now, let's just pop that back out there. Now, I was telling you about the tips. So in this rod, I've got a 3/4 ounce tip. And the reason that tip is so important is for one of the reasons that you just saw a minute ago. It allows me to read all the bites really clearly. So I don't want a big stiff tip because I've only got a 12 gram feeder on. So if a fish tries to bounce into the feeder or give me a line bite, if I've got a big stiff tip, all that's gonna happen is the feeder's gonna move before the tip will bend round. Whereas with a nice light tip, like I've got here, I can effectively watch the fish swim into the line and the tip will just give or come back. Or if a little fish picks it up, I can read those little tremors. And then I can see the difference in those big, steady pull rounds from these big F1s. I've had mostly those sort of steady pull rounds which indicate there's a fish on, just a lot quicker than what a liner would be. But I've also had two indications where it's bent round like that, a nice decent bend, obviously not a small fish, and then the tips drop completely slack, which means the fish has picked up the bait and swam away and dislodged the feeder. So by having the light tip in for this style of fishing, it means there's a lot better form of presentation in keeping the feeder still and reading the bites. So don't go for big heavy tips when you're on these small commercials. These lighter tips, which blend beautifully into the rods, are always going to be the number one choice. Well, it's been really interesting. I've caught lots of fish today, to be fair. I think around about 15 or 18 fish. I've lost count, but it's been really nice fishing. And the fish have been backing off the bait all over. I've had to go right into the den there in front of me. I've actually edged across slightly to my left. And I'd probably say the best feeders, it's touch and go, but I'd say the little cage has been my sort of, if I had to pick one, I think that they are coming to that little bit of bait just a bit quicker, although I have had some nice fish on the maggot feeder as well. But what I'm going to do for this final cast, and probably two or three casts right at the end of the day, is there's a lovely reed bed to my right, and what I've done is I've kept edging further and further away from that. So I'm hoping that the fish have settled towards that reed bed for a nice little finish before I pack away. So I know that my clip's going to be roughly right. I've put my little cage on because it's my favourite for today, and I'm just going to chuck it. There we go, just on the edge of that reed bed there to the right. I haven't cast there at all day. It went in really quietly, very nicely to be fair. I think there's a great chance of two or three early fish there. When I went a little bit further across and to the left, I actually caught a beautiful common carp, a really nice fish, around 8 or 9 pounds, which was a lovely bonus on a day like today. So you never know, this first cast or second cast here might throw me up another carp as well. So it'd be a great way to finish the session, add at least 50 or 60 pounds, because they're great big fish that we've been catching. A lovely winter's day on the ICM with a lovely comfortable setup. Nothing not to like. Hopefully I'll get another couple to finish the day. It's been really good. Well, managed to sneak one on that line. It's actually the second chuck there, not the first unfortunately, but a nice great big F1 to finish. A cracking day here at Packington. It just goes to show, using those small feeders and searching your peg, you can have a fantastic winter day's fishing with great big fish, just like that.